way.
What's he doing now?
He's turning. Drilling right for us.
Yeah.
What is it?
Coast Guard. We know who you are.
Unto him, O Lord, may he rest in peace. May his soul and the soul of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen. In the name of the Father, the Spirit of the Son, the Son. Amen.
Grant, O Lord, we beseech thee, thy mercy unto thy servant departed, that having in desire kept thy will, he may not suffer in requital for his deeds. Amen.
Amen. In the name of the Father, Spirit of the Son, the Son. Amen.
As a true faith joined him unto the company of thy faithful here below, so may thy tender mercy give him place above among the angel choirs. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
There's a rumor that you might be considering certain reprisals against the party or parties responsible for the demise of the late Mr. Scarlatti.
Interesting rumor.
This is going to get worse before it gets better.
It's a possibility.
I don't want you around steaming up my glasses.
You're a terrible grouch this morning.
I simply cannot afford another ulcer. There's no more room.
Then relax.
I try, I swear.
Enjoy the good life.
Help me. Show me the way.
Something about a new grave makes me want to run a 4-minute mile, get drunk, and shack up with a redhead. Not necessarily in that order.
I get a taste for my mother's chicken soup.
Immortality is a happy childhood.
What's your point?
We grow up and we die. Worrying about it just gets us there a little sooner.
Trite, but not very original. Tell you what I'll do. I'll promise to stop worrying if you promise to butt out. After all, what did Scarlatti ever do for you?
Saved my life.
Sure, but what else?
You've got a point, Lieutenant.
Hey there, Mr. Gunn.
Good morning.
You know, Fusco, if anyone else called this a good morning, I would be inclined to doubt their judgment or their choice of words.
A word of advice, Mr. Gunn. Now that Julia's no longer with us, the task of running the business naturally falls to his successor.
Naturally.
And I'm going to be very busy making some changes.
And I could be one of them.
I couldn't have put it better myself. Goodbye, Mr. Gunn.
I was going to ask you to have a talk with Fusco, but I changed my mind.
Have a talk with Fusco? About what?
Two of his boys were in to see me. Fusco wants 50% of the action. 50%! Beach!
That's almost half.
Well, to hell with him. I'm not going to do it.
I'm with you.
Will you still be with me when the waters of the river close over my head?
Well, don't you want somebody left behind to protest you going?
Think you could get Fusco to lay off?
You think you could store Lake Michigan in your basement?
Included, among other things, a certain degree of instability.
I refuse to stand here and allow my professional reputation to be challenged by a fresh-faced novice.
I'm scared. Kiss me, it's like skywriting. I can always tell when you're not gonna stick around. It's, what do you call it?
Conditioned reflex?
Yeah.
Will I see you later?
How much later?
Do you consider that an insurmountable obstacle?
Not in terms of minutes. Hours. Or even days. But if I have to wait like a week, I'll need a change of clothes and some tranquilizers.
She's under the mat.
Hello, Archie.
Daisy Jane wants to see you.
When?
Now.
Now?
It's important.
Daisy Jane wants to see me.
When?
Now.
No?
It's important.
How about that?
It's just business.
Naturally.
It won't take long.
I'm surprised you admit it.
Bye, silly.
You a drink, Mr. Gunn?
Not now, thank you, Jimmy.
Buonasera.
Ciao.
Buonasera.
Ciao.
Hiya, Peter, honey.
Hiya.
Hello, Peter.
Daisy.
Come on, huh?
Come on, I'll buy you a drink.
What's the trouble?
How'd you know there's any trouble?
You get tight around the eyes.
Maybe I'm just frustrated. How do you know I didn't just get you over here to seduce you?
That doesn't get you tight around the eyes.
Usual, Mr. Gunn?
Not tonight, thank you, Charlie.
Wie geht es Ihnen, Peter?
Oh, danke. Gut. Which one is that?
I don't know. You've been busy lately?
Personally or professionally?
I'll pay you $10,000 to find out who killed Giulio Scarlatti.
Mr. Fusco being difficult?
Mr. Fusco's decided to take over my territory. He'll let me stick around and run things for a nominal percent of the net.
Suppose I find out who killed Scarlatti and it isn't Mr. Fusco.
Maybe Nick Fusco didn't pull the trigger, but it's a lead pipe since he gave the order. Get him for me, Pete. I'm a hustler, but I don't like being hustled.
I'll think about it.
Besides, you owe Scarlatti something for saving your life.
I know what I owe him, Daisy. So don't shove. You're not the only one that doesn't like being hustled.
Excuse me.
I'll see you later, lover. Hmm.
You said you were expecting him. I told you what would happen if you lied to me.
What would you say if I asked you to lay off Mother?
Go to hell.
See you around.
I'd better get a doctor.
Yes. Then get somebody to kill Mr. Gunn.
Make a wish.
Collecting for the heart fund?
No. No, I'm not.
Girl Scout cookies?
No.
Community?
Yeah.
I gave last month.
Oh. Sorry to hear that.
Now, name, rank, serial number?
You mean how come I call this meeting?
Yes, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, I saw you at Mother's a week ago Tuesday, and I just had to meet you. Want to discuss it?
How did you get in?
Your bed?
At my apartment.
I gave the manager $50. Don't you like me?
What's your name?
Samantha. Call me Sam.
Sam?
You called?
Checkout time.
You don't know what you're missing.
Well, I know what you'll be missing if my friend shows up before you're out of here.
Okay. But, you at least ought to give me a rain check.
Sam.
Hmm?
You can have a whole bunch of rain checks.
Pete?
Hi.
Sam. Sam.
Oh, baby.
Sam, what's the 30?
Oh, darling, will you... Oh, baby.
Sam.
Sam.
What?
Pete?
Hi there.
Hi.
Hi.
You said that.
Huh? What?
You all right?
No.
You look a little flushed.
Flushed? Yeah, well, as a matter of fact, I'm not feeling very well. In fact, I'm not feeling well at all. But then, it's nothing a little mouth-to-mouth resuscitation won't cure.
All right. That wouldn't revive Tom Thumb.
Hey, well, you know the old saying.
A stitch in time saves nine.
Yeah, stone roll gathers no boss.
Meaning?
Well, I was hoping you could tell me.
Pete.
Oh.
In the kitchen?
Well, there might be kicks in the kitchen.
Drive up the coast and have breakfast.
I thought you weren't feeling well.
Yeah, well, get a little fresh air. I'll be as fit as a fiddle.
Pete? Who's in the bedroom?
What?
No, not what. Who?
Who could possibly be in my bedroom?
Pete, be careful!
Of yours?
Not really.
I was on my way over to discuss a nasty little rumor that's been circulating. It seems that in certain circles, you're considered socially unfit and definitely expendable.
That's strange. They love me in Boston.
Is this all of it?
If you mean, did he have any friends?
I mean, knowing you, there should be a few more dead bodies lying around that might need my professional attention.
He was all alone.
Were you?
No, I was... Oh.
What?
Edie.
What about Edie?
I left Edie upstairs with Sam. Edie!
Boy, what a memory.
Who's Sam?
Yeah, who's Sam?
Yeah, well, now look, Edie. Edie.
What was that all about?
Sam's a girl.
Well, how the hell would I know that?
You know me. Remember Isidore?
Hey, whatever happened to her?
She had a terrible accident. She married a cop.
What do you mean I have to go?
Sam, dear.
Listen, what do you mean? You lure me up here, get me undressed, get me all excited, and this dum-dum I don't even know crashes the party and tries to kill me. And then some weirdo old lady calls me a slut and ties up my clothes in great big knots. Look at that!
Dear Sam.
Oh, sure. Why not? What do you want with me now that you've used me?
Now that I've used you?
Yeah.
Used you for what?
How do I know? All this running and shooting and hiding. Maybe some crazy new kind of perversion. Maybe that's how you and your girlfriend get your kicks. Ah!
Sam, I...
Don't judge me, you pervert!
really think I'm a pervert?
I don't know. Maybe.
Fine. Then you can go.
No.
No.
No. I'm strange.
Strange. Well, then, Sam, I'm going.
Really?
I've got to go. You're very sweet.
Strange.
Strange. Now, look, Sam, I'm not rejecting you. No, not at all. But, Sam, please, be gone before I get back, huh?
I love you. You're so innocent.
Yeah, well... happened to the 4th of July?
One might very well ask. However, unless I'm growing forgetful, I suspect there's still three jolly fingers of Thanksgiving in the loo. Handsomely rewarded in one of my future reincarnations. Provided you're still around. Sweet nectar.
How would you like a whole case of nectar?
I would adore it. Things are not quite as gay as they're painted here as the senior citizen drag show.
Sorry.
No one to blame but ourselves. We were dumb enough to be conned by promotional brochures. They still haven't found the miniature golf course.
The nectar?
Ah, yes, the nectar. Is that a bona fide offer?
It's a bona fide offer.
But what an exchange. I have a sudden and chilling foreboding, sir, that you frankly covet my drapes.
Heard any good sea stories lately?
Ah, the lathe and little Miss Julio Scotty. Puzzling death, wouldn't you say?
I was about to say something like that, yes.
But then death is puzzling in general. I've heard that it's a disease. One more common than the common cold.
Who could have gotten aboard that boat without Scarlatti putting up a fight?
Man of daring, man of brilliance, man of uncommon imagination.
Fact?
Mere opinion. Based on uncanny intuition and a compelling obligation to keep up my end of the conversation.
See what you can find out.
I must warn you, sir, that bribing a village elder carries some rather harsh penalties.
I see. Well, what would you suggest?
Settle out in court, and I'll give you the tapes of this conversation.
Does that do it?
If you mean, does it send unbelievable vibrations shooting up my spine and a sympathetic reassurance pulsing into my affection-starved liver, Peter, dear boy, yes, that does it.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
What do you mean you broke in?
I think I just found something that might tickle your professional fancy. A cigarette lighter. One of those things you use to light cigarettes? Without commenting on your fine-tooth comb cliche, might I advance the theory that one of your detectives missed it? One of your well-trained, efficient, nearsighted detectives?
10 minutes.
Thank you.
Make yourselves comfortable, gentlemen. I'll get Daisy Jane. The part of your nose.
You ever hear anything about Fusco and Daisy Jane?
By anything, do you mean something that would explain that lighter?
You know what I mean.
No, I haven't heard a thing. Have you?
No. I still don't see how we could have missed it.
The lighter?
My upper plate.
Oh.
It's possible it was planted after the fact.
Your upper plate?
The lighter. You got in, why not somebody else?
Maybe I planted it. Maybe I wanted to frame Mr. Fusco.
It has possibilities. Daisy Jane offered you $10,000 to get rid of Fusco.
Daisy Jane offered me $10,000 to find out who killed Scarlatti.
She was positive you'd turn up Fusco.
I wasn't.
Maybe you changed your mind. People have for a lot less than $10,000.
Mercenary people, people without virtue or principle.
Don't spend it all in one place.
I am not only a pillar of virtue, I am independently wealthy. Besides, I have my reputation to consider.
Let's hear it for Pete Gunn's reputation.
What's the beef, Lieutenant?
No beef.
Hello, Peter. What's it all about?
Fusco.
What about Fusco? Where'd you get that?
Pete found it on Scarlatti's boat.
You're kidding.
About an hour ago.
The inscription reads...
I know what the inscription reads. I gave that lighter to Nick Fusco the day after Scarlatti had left on his vacation.
Day after?
Right. You can check with the jeweler. I picked it up on the 18th and gave it to Fusco that night. He told me Scarlatti had left on his boat the day before.
Doesn't look very good for Mr. Fusco, does it?
Did Pete tell you about our little deal?
He told me that you had offered $10,000 to find out who killed Scarlatti.
Will you take a check?
You think the lighter sews it up?
How else did it get on the boat?
Someone could have planted it.
Or Fusco could have dropped it when he blasted Scarlatti.
We're certainly considering that possibility.
What are you being so damn finicky for? You want Fusco more than I do.
Do I?
Why don't you?
I don't know. How bad do you want him?
$10,000 worth.
I may be just a thick cop. But I find it hard to reconcile a $10,000 bounty with a solid gold lighter inscribed with love.
The love and the lighter came before Mr. Fusco became such a big man and started shoving me around. You want to ask me anything else? You talk to my lawyer.
That's not being very cooperative.
Look, Jacoby, you want cooperation? You come up with a little yourself. In my racket, you get the best results when both parties cooperate. You want the money or not, Peter?
It's on the house.
If I was stupid enough to make an offer like that, I'd be out of business in a week. Good night, boys.
What is it you want?
Call Whiteside. So what?
Yours?
We wait for Whiteside.
Okay. We'll wait for him at the station.
What's the charge?
Suspicion of murder.
You're going to arouse me once too often, Jacoby.
You got a choice. You answer a few questions before your lawyer gets here, come down to the station and answer them there.
Whiteside's on his way.
Sit down, I need a witness.
What's it all about?
Just sit down. Okay, that's my lighter. You're bound to find it out sooner or later. All you have to do is ask Daisy Jane.
I asked Daisy Jane, and she said that she gave you the lighter the day after Scarlatti sailed.
Don't you think we ought to wait for Whiteside?
Just keep quiet. I'm not sure what day it was.
You don't know whether it was after or before Scarlatti sailed?
No. What's the difference?
I found the lighter on the boat.
The last time I saw Scarlatti was the day before he sailed. And the last time I was on that boat was July. 4th of July weekend.
Can you prove it?
I was with a young lady the night he was killed.
What young lady?
Nancy Harris, Roy Dale Apartments, 608.
You have no idea how the lighter might have gotten on board the Tempest.
Nope. I thought I'd lost it.
When did you think you'd lost it?
A couple of days ago. I spent most of the day at the club. Obviously, you see, somebody lifted it and planted it on the boat.
Things are much more obvious to you than they are to me. There must be something I can do about that.
Yes, why don't you have a talk with Gunn? He found the lighter. Maybe he knows how it got there.
You know how it got there?
Nope.
He doesn't know.
And it's not possible that he could be lying.
Is it possible?
Yeah, it's possible.
It's possible.
You know, your boys have got yourself a very funny act.
Well, that's very nice of you to say so.
I see what I can do about getting you an audition with a police commission.
Wonderful. And in the meantime, I'll see this Nancy Harris. If she doesn't remember spending the weekend with you, we'll have another talk. Okay?
The chief of the Farmers Grain...
Miss Harris!
Valley says the government's elimination...
Miss Harris! There's something wrong with the lights. What if she comes home and finds us rummaging around in her apartment?
I'll explain.
Well, would you mind telling me what this is all about?
I told you, I want to talk to her.
Government farm expert has told newsmen... The Agriculture Department may decide to relax its surplus reduction program for Central Valley cotton next year. Whether that happens or not depends to a great extent on what happens to this year's crop and to the surplus carryover. As of the end of this year, the surplus is expected to be down to about 12 million bales. And on the basis of current guesses, the surplus could be cut to about 9 million bales. There has been a new proposal for a compromise plan to provide supplemental financing for rural electric cooperatives. It comes from the Kansas Power.
Cause a little difficulty. So stand by, Dick.
What kind of neighborhood is this? Now it's a helicopter freak.
This is Captain Brady again. Just checked out the problem, and everything's all clear. So now back to the Dick Merriweather show.
A girl can't even take a sun bath.
Yeah, but that was Captain Brady.
I don't care if it was Captain Marvel. He's a dirty old man.
Yeah, well.
Hey, did he get a tan on my...
Yes.
How's it look?
Well, there's much to be said for both sides.
I missed you.
Sam, I thought you were going home.
I thought so, too. Hey, look, I got a freckle. Aw, you look beat.
Yeah, well, I am beat, Sam. I am beat to a positive frazzle.
Well, I didn't get much sleep either. Why don't we go in?
Sam.
Aw, speak.
Why? Why are you still here?
I just couldn't get my clothes in.
Oh, come on.
Honest, I tried everything. Sam. Look, I broke three nails, nearly lost a front tooth.
Look, I'll get you some more clothes.
I already sent for some.
Sent where for some?
I called up a store. They're going to deliver. In the meantime?
Yeah, in the meantime, that weird old lady that tied those knots in your clothes is just liable to show up and kill both of us.
Really?
It's a possibility.
Delivery for Miss Strickland?
Oh, I'll sign for her.
Thank you, Miss Strickland.
I hope you like apricot.
It's my favorite color, especially this morning. It matches my eye. I'll start the coffee.
It's already started.
Well, I'll pour the coffee.
I'll only be a second.
Just remember that in situations like this, every second counts.
Ooh!
What do you mean, ooh?
It's adorable.
What do you do, Sam?
What do you like?
I mean, what's your occupation?
I travel in money.
What?
I'm rich. I don't do anything.
Why haven't we met before?
I'm from out of town.
Where?
Denver.
Denver?
Like a sandwich.
How do you take your coffee?
Just a little cream, please.
Now look, Sam.
Groovy?
Stay. Now, that's a nightgown, right?
Right.
That's what you ordered from the store?
Well, it's not easy getting just what you want over the phone. Turned out all right.
You mean that's all you ordered?
Oh, no.
Oh, good.
I ordered three others just like this, in different colors.
In case I didn't like apricot.
Yeah. Red, white, and blue.
Now, come on, Sam.
You can go to hell. You cannot hold me. You got nothing on me, not even a parking ticket. I know my rights.
Sergeant Ashford? He knows his rights.
Oh, I knew. I knew the minute I saw him. I said, now there is a man who knows his rights.
I don't believe you guys. You know he's been double-crossing you. He's been playing the same funny act with Peter Gunn. Now, come on. You've got no evidence. Whiteside will be here with a writ any minute.
In the meantime, I'd like to know how Nancy Harris got herself electrocuted.
How in the hell should I know?
Your prints are all over the place.
Well, I spent some time there, I told you. What am I going to do, kill my alibi?
Maybe she decided not to be your alibi.
Maybe. All you've got is a bunch of maybes. It's about time you got here.
Sorry. Don't you ever learn?
Yeah. Each time I learn.
Maybe.
If you find my shoes, you know where to reach me.
Goodbye, Sam.
Ciao.
Or something.
time you had breakfast before 3 p.m.
Yesterday, 2:45.
That should be some kind of a record. Well, it's obvious this depressing establishment is Farmer's liquor license.
Have a beer.
Oh, Peter. Even alcoholics have a caste system. To suggest a beer to one of the 100-proof elite is like offering Count Dracula chicken soup. Good morning, my dear.
Coffee?
No stimulants, doctor's orders. But I will have a carafe of your best wine.
Thank you.
And a cornucopia of roses, that I may strew them in your path wherever you go, forever and ever, ad infinitum. Sweet.
What's new?
A vessel of size and importance, recently painted in detail to resemble a ship of the United States Coast Guard. Does that make you tingle, Peter? Vintage, but...
Caviar's not too good either.
I know. Things are bad everywhere.
Yeah. Let me know if you hear if anybody wants to buy my Ferrari.
Delighted. Nature's child in a forest of despair.
You, left me tingling.
Ah, yes. But the ultimate excitation may require more coin of the realm. Not from myself, as you might imagine, but from my source of information. He is generous, you understand, but not to a fault.
I understand.
The price is 200.
You can tell your source that I will stand the tariff, if you think he's worth it.
He's a talented but little-known painter. Shall we say, deserving of recognition?
I see.
The horse's mouth, so to speak. And tonight, at 7, I shall offer to cram it with sugar and carrots. So, I shall call you, Great White Hunter, at the rising of the moon. And farewell, my Lady Miracle. Think of me as one who loved not wisely, but too badly.
Thought you'd like to know who tried to kill you last night. His name was Leo Gracie, from Detroit. Ever heard of him?
No.
Long record of arrests. 2 convictions. We can't find anything that ties him up with Fusco.
You woke me up for that?
You want to sleep, put up a sign.
What time is it?
9:05.
Still Thursday?
P.M.
You would take her had a $200 appointment tonight. You should have checked in.
$200 for what?
Well, there's a good possibility that Scarlatti let his killer board the Tempest because he thought they were the Coast Guard.
You gotta keep messing around with this thing until it blows up right in your face.
Pick, 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 pick.
According to Leo Gracie's record, he also served a 4-year hitch in the United States Coast Guard.
What happened? What? What is it?
I think it's cleaning fluid. What did he say?
Lazarette.
What?
It's what it sounded like, Lazarette.
What's it mean?
How the hell do I know? For the bishop.
Oh, yeah?
I was told to ask for Rasputin.
You were, huh?
The name's Gunn.
Groovy.
Hey, man. Look.
Somebody's calling you, man.
You calling me? Hey, man.
He's calling you again.
I'm looking for the bishop.
Sure, man.
What's the matter, man? Can't you hear?
The bishop?
Sure.
I think he's deaf, Scummy.
He's rude.
You deaf, man?
He's rich, Scummy.
Rich, man?
That won't even begin to pay your hospital bill.
Hey, Groovy, I dig that real cool threat with the muscles flexed. I bet you're one of those karate experts, right?
Kiss him!
One move and zap, I'm wiped out, right? Watch it, man.
Bake your own bread, man.
Hey, man, I'm getting tired of guessing. Who are you?
Look, man, even if I told you, you wouldn't believe me.
Oh, yeah?
Take my word, it's unbelievable. I mean, man, I don't even believe it myself. Do I get the bishop?
Do I get another five?
I'll believe it, man.
In the arcade.
You didn't answer me, man.
I'm the man that's gonna shoot you in the stomach if you don't let go. Man.
Hear about Tinker?
Yeah. I heard somebody spiked his jug with canned heat.
It was cleaning fluid.
Were you there?
He managed to say something that sounded like lazarette.
I'm surprised he could say anything.
It wasn't easy.
Lazarette, huh?
What does that mean?
Look, why don't you go back and get your picture taken?
Lazarette, huh?
I'll narrow it down for you. A, it's local. Harbor area. B, it's got something to do with repainting a boat to make it resemble a Coast Guard boat.
Oh, I see.
Do you?
Yeah. But, considering what happened to Tinker...
Will 20 do the trick?
No trick. It just, you know, takes the right combination.
I already gave Rasputin 10.
Well, I only take 15% of his action. He gets 10 of mine.
25.
Try 30. Bless you. The only lazarette I can think of that fits the bill's a marine hardware store on Riverfront. Run by an ex-con named Laszlo Joyce.
Here we'll stay.
What's new and exciting?
Rats.
What?
We've got them back. They've been making a hell of a racket.
Mm.
950.
Have you heard any more from Fusco?
I got a call. Some crude fink warned me to make up my mind by midnight or else. 1,000.
Or else what?
He didn't elaborate.
What's 1, after 000. Three?
Well, maybe he figured I'd collapse from lack of sleep. 1,150.
1,000,000.
1,000,000.
Petey?
Oh, I'm sorry, Al.
Standing on
Petey, now look.
Oh. Edie!
Edie! Edie! Edie!
I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your door down. At least you ought to give me back my Letterman sweater. Come on, silly. This is ridiculous.
Do you have a light? Thanks.
Well, look at it this way. Sooner or later, you've got to go home. Unless you open the window and jump in the river, you've got to open this door to pass me.
Passed you last night.
But I have never seen her before in my life.
Before what?
Before I came home and found her in my bed.
And where is Goldilocks of the Hooker set tonight?
Well, she's not in my bed.
Why not? She obviously has a key.
She has not obviously got a key. She bribed the landlord.
Really?
She gave him $50.
Why?
What?
Why?
Why did she give him $50?
Mm-hmm.
Because she wanted to get into my apartment.
Why?
Well, she...
It's a fairly simple question. Why did she want to get into your apartment?
Well, she said she had seen me at Mother's one night and...
Yes.
Well, and she just decided that she, you know, had to meet me. Edie, it's true. May God strike me dead if it isn't the gospel truth.
Some kind of nut?
Mother?
Oh.
Mother.
Boy, when we get rats, we get big rats.
It looks like dynamite. It's simple. Somebody crawled into the building, set a long fuse. Dynamite.
Are you going to pick up Fusco?
No.
Why not?
I'll pick him up when I've got some proof.
Well, it never stopped you before.
It never got me anything either. Next time I bust Fusco, I'm going to make it stick. I want him just as much as you do.
If you wanted him just as much as I do, you would have picked him up an hour ago.
Pete! I'll go after you just as fast as I go after Fusco.
Then I've got nothing to worry about.
He's headed for trouble.
I guess so.
Can't you do something?
Sure. What do you want me to sing?
Swell.
All right, you drive. I've been drinking.
I warned you, Gunn. But I guess you just didn't understand, did you?
I guess I didn't.
Then you shouldn't get too surprised at the consequences.
I'll try not to be.
Up against the wall. Against the wall. So there won't be any more misunderstandings. I didn't kill Julius Carlotti or Nancy Harris.
Why tell me?
Because you're going to prove it. I'll give you 24 hours.
How about Tinker and Mother? There's a 50-50 chance Mother won't make it.
Well, it's reasonable to assume whoever is trying to frame me is the same person that killed Tinker and dynamited Mother.
How did you know it was dynamite?
I know a lot of things. I know it was dynamite. I know Tinker drank cleaning fluid. And I know the girl was electrocuted. I also know that unless you come up with an answer within 24 hours, you're going to find yourself on the bottom of the river trying to swim your way out of a sack.
This address?
Yeah, 1133 Riverfront.
Hmm.
Are you Joyce?
No. Maybe I can find it for you. Cab's paid for. I told him to leave if you're not out in 5 minutes.
Why should it take me 5 minutes?
It shouldn't if you come up with some fast answers.
What kind of fast answers?
Whose idea was the phony Coast Guard boat?
Thank you.
unless I find out who killed Scarlatti. Nick Fusco says he's going to have me killed. And knowing Mr. Fusco, I have every reason to believe he'll do just that. So I've got nothing to lose, Mr. Joyce. Either you tell me what I want to know, or I'll put a bullet right between your eyes.
Jacoby.
Leo Gracie hired Laszlo Joyce to paint and outfit a surplus Coast Guard boat. Together with Gracie, they sailed the boat to a defunct shipyard located on Harrow Island, where Laszlo did whatever painting was necessary. Well, Laszlo said he never talked to anybody but Gracie. Now, he swears that he didn't know what the boat was for until he read that Scarlatti was killed, then he put two and two together. Well, one night he followed Gracie to an address on Sona Street.
He says that Gracie visited a man who was listed on the mailbox as George Gethers.
Never heard of him.
Yeah, well, while I check out Mr. Gethers, why don't you see if that Coast Guard boat is still stashed on Harrow Island?
Pete.
Laszlo will be waiting for you. 1133 Riverfront.
Now, wait a minute.
Oh, come on, Fatty. Make like a policeman. This is the home stretch. One more thing. How'd you know I was looking for you?
I didn't.
Then why blow town?
Well, somebody tried to kill me last night. I was just coming home from the movie and a car tried to run me over.
Hmm. Say ah.
What? Mm.
Thank you.
You need a shave, lover.
Maybe I'll grow a beard.
No, I don't think I'd like you with a beard.
I don't think I'd like you with a beard either.
Not a chance. What is it?
Receipt for the gold cigarette lighter you gave Nick Fusco. I found it in the possession of one Harry Ross, who was living in an apartment leased by Mr. George Gathers. They were, it seems, very good friends.
Were?
Ross is dead. But before he died, he told me that it was Gathers that planned Scarlatti's assassination. Gathers stayed on board the Coast Guard boat that night while Ross and Gracie boarded the Tempest and murdered four people.
Was Gathers working for Fusco?
In a way, he was. But Fusco didn't know it. You see, Gathers was really two people. To Ross and Gracie, he was Mr. George Gathers. Handsome, wealthy, mysterious. But to Fusco, he was someone else. Someone who was willing to kill so that Fusco could inherit the Scarlatti Empire. And then something happened. Maybe it was Fusco's newfound power or the discovery that Fusco was having an affair with Nancy Harris. Whatever it was enough to make Fusco want to destroy him. He made it look like Fusco was threatening you and Mother so that I would get involved and find that lighter that was planted on the Tempest. Then he murdered Nancy Harris, Fusco's only alibi. You see, Fusco was telling the truth when he claimed he had lost that lighter at the athletic club. I checked. Gathers became a member there 2 days after Scarlatti was killed. See, as Gathers, he could roam around the club without suspicion. And as Fusco's former friend, he would have had access to Fusco's locker key. Then as Gathers, stolen the lighter.
Busy little man.
Very. Sent Gracie up my fire escape to take a shot at me. He even bombed Mother's to make it look as if Fusco was trying to make good his threats.
He saved your life.
Well, the spear gun? Well, he had no choice. You see, if he'd let Fusco's man kill me, who would have told Jacoby about the lighter? No, Mr. Gathers hasn't many redeeming qualities. In fact, one might even say that Mr. Gathers is certainly no lady.
You bastard! I'll get her! Oh!
Why, Sam?
I'm Giulio Scarlatti's daughter.
Mazel tov.
Sink the Bismarck.
When did Mother start attracting this segment of society?
Don't you approve?
My theory is that the human race is just a temporary experiment on Earth, and that the experiment is failing.
You're just pessimistic because Merzidos didn't make the top 40 this week.
Lieutenant.
What is it, Bernard?
I need your professional advice. See if that isn't ginger ale.
She was really Scarlatti's daughter.
I take an oath?
No, don't.
Now, well, she was Scarlatti's daughter by... Right. Wait a minute. She was Scarlatti's daughter by his first wife. It was a well-kept secret until the mother died about 5 years ago. Then Scarlatti had to tell Sam that he was her father.
How did she take it?
Well, she resented it at first, but... he made sure she had everything. He evidently spent a lot of time with her, and she grew to love him very much.
And ended up in your bed.
She ended up in my bed because she figured that sooner or later, I would lead her to her father's killer.
And will she have to go to jail?
Oh, I doubt it. Probably a suspended sentence and probation.
Well, I'll see you later.
I am going home and sleep.
I won't disturb you.
Yeah, well, then what's the sense?
Well, I mean, you have to wake up sometime.
Hey, that's right. How about that?
That's what I mean. How about it?
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Sam's. She asked me to return your coat.
What's your name?
Ernestine. Call me Ernie.
Ernie, huh?
Former friend, don't you play with the Norris VP. I'm going wild.